What is the Cthulhu monster in the movie The Relic? Released in 1997, this movie is about an anthropologist working for the Natural History Museum in Chicago. He travels to South America to study a newly discovered tribe. While there, they prepare a special soup for him and he drinks it. He learns about the tale of the Cthulhu creature during his time there. He also packs some leaves with a special fungus to be shipped back to the museum along with some artifacts, but later learns the fungus is very dangerous and tries to stop the shipment of it, but he fails. The fungal leaves were used by this tribe to mutate an existing life form into a beast that would be used against their enemies. The creature would mainly feed off the hormones contained within the leaves, but when that supply ran out, it would hunt down humans in search of a substitute for its food source. Some notes indicated that its transformation also included saurian or reptilian DNA that was inserted into a host. Later on in the film, a DNA test of the creature revealed that it was actually John Whitney, the anthropologist that went to South America. The soup that was given to him by the tribe must have contained something that transformed him into the Cthulhu monster. The novel of the movie said its original name was called Mabuan, which stood for He Who Walks on All Fours, but the name was changed to Cthulhu during its movie adaptation. Its physical appearance was best described as a scaly primate. It was listed as being as smart as a human, but also as fast as a greyhound. Now, its body was massive, armored, and muscular. It also left behind a specific smell that was unique to the creature. Its face had large mandibles that would cut off the head of its victim. These mandibles would resemble what is seen on a stag beetle. Its spine was hairy, while the tail looked very reptilian. Now, its tongue was forked and the teeth were very sharply curved. Although it walked on all fours, it seemed to move and jump like a big cat. The Cthulhu creature was an ancient predator known mainly by some remote South American tribes. They believe this creature was the son of Satan. The fungus that was found on the leaves only grows on one specific species of plant, and through a virus, it infects the plant and takes over some of its cells. The leaf is then heavily laced with these animal proteins. This results in growth, bone structure, exoskeletal physiology, and skin maintenance. When a huge amount of these proteins are inserted or ingested into a host, it causes dramatic physical changes. This was shown when one character named Dr. Margot Green found a large beetle in a container full of the leaves. She ran some tests and noticed this was a domestic beetle, but it was so large because it fed off these proteins, which made it larger and more hostile. The Cthulhu can also hold its breath for a long time while swimming, jump long distances, and climb up walls. It would reach around 7 feet tall and 15 feet long from its tail. The tribe would use the infected plant to create the Cthulhu creature in a time of need. Then they would go into hiding and unleash it upon their enemies. When there were no more leaves to eat, the Cthulhu would hunt humans. Now, a part of the human brain, known as the hypothalamus, would produce the hormones it needed to survive. But when it had no more humans to hunt, the creature would die out. The Cthulhu was defeated by fire and an explosion. Although this was the only movie about this legend, there was a sequel written in a novel called Reliquary. Now, the relic taken from Brazil was supposed to be the image of the Cthulhu sitting on top of the skulls of its victims. This monster had a very unique design, and I feel it's one of those forgotten creatures in horror. Its head was actually inspired by the design of a spider, and its toes were inverted raptor claws. Now, its entire physical and genetic makeup was a combination of a tiger, reptile, spider, stag beetle, and a human as a host. Now, they did build a giant suit during production, but some movements led to difficulties, so they used special effects for some scenes. So, what did you think about this creature? Let me know in the comment section. If you want to see more content like this, then leave a like on this video and subscribe with notifications turned on. I hope you enjoyed this video. Thanks for watching. My name is Carlos, and I'll see you in the next video.